Hi, this is Jeff Merrill from Shenzhen, China, and today we're going to look at the Bering 65. Bering 65 has double walk-around side decks. They're very wide. I have good railings on the sides, into the pilot house or up to the foredeck. Underway is just going to be spectacular. I've had a chance to do some running on the boat. She's very quiet, no vibration, smooth, silky through the water. And again, I have just a fantastic view from where I'm sitting. It's a very comfortable chair. I can see everything. I can see all my surroundings. I love this pilot house. In addition to this exceptional layout, one very telling feature on how well the bearings are constructed is that the dB reading up in the pilot house was only 48. We were running at 1200 RPM, which is a nice cruising speed, going 8 knots, and the dB reading was 48. The engine room was 91, so they've done an incredible job at bearing, getting the noise level down. With the partition down and the pocket door open, I have great access and visibility to the pilot house. I can talk to the crew on watch, and I can easily come back to the galley to see what's going on back here. On the port side of the galley, I have two isotherm refrigerator drawers below me, a microwave convection oven, and then electric breaker panel up top. The salon on the Bering 65 is very comfortable. The seats are deep, they're tall, I have excellent sight lines out the windows. For entertainment, I have a flat screen TV on the lift forward, and also for entertainment, I've got a very large wine bottle storage locker on the port side. Easy steps up to the galley and the pilot house or down to the staterooms. This is the place where everybody's going to hang out when it's time for dinner or just for relaxing. From the salon, you come down a centerline flight of stairs. There's a guest stateroom to starboard, the master stateroom forward, and another guest stateroom to port. There's an additional short set of steps right here on the port side that leads back to an electrical hallway. The captain's stateroom is right below the salon, and you can also get straight back to the engine room. The master stateroom is huge. It's protected by a collision bulkhead that also has a chain locker forward, but it's a nice queen-size berth on centerline. It's nice height too. It's easy to get on and off the bed. This master stateroom head is perfectly sized. There's a nice sink inboard, big stand-up shower outboard with a teak grate and opening port light. I've got some locker storage spaces, a mirror, even a towel drying rack. At the foot of the master stateroom bed is a very large opening hatch. This lifts up on a gas spring to reveal a huge storage locker. This cavernous space is ideal for storing long-range provisions and all types of extra gear. It's just a wonderful place to tuck things away.
The true highlight of the Bering 65 is the engine room with standing headroom. All of the weight is down low. I have two Cummins engines. Both are mounted down in the gondola skegs. Behind me, I have the water maker. I have the sea chest forward to center line. Also the center line and just after the two O-N-N generators. Everything is easy to move around here. Good walking side pass. I can get back to the lazarette or forward to the living spaces. All the rigors are formed with a steel tray below them. This is really just a very easy engine room to come down for inspections, for service, and to keep everything running nice.
There's a nice big stainless steel plate here with two bollards and a warping winch, a cutaway in the actual hull with the automatic fairing from stainless steel, and then all the doors outside are fiberglass and louvered, so very easy to get to.
The bow of the Bering 65 stands about 12 feet above the water. This is a true passage-making yacht. You can see she's got very nice hawse pipes for docking, but more importantly, there's a very good chain locker here. There are two massive end-type anchors that feed up to two hydraulic windlasses. The mud trays keep the mud off the deck, and it all collects down into a divided chain locker. I love the teak decking up here, and this is a very spacious area. This is a nice outdoor living space. There are bench seats for enjoying the ride underway or when you're at anchor.
Flybridge is up high, very stable up here. You have a nice LeBrock helm chair, all your basic electronics forward. The Venturi wraps all the way around to the aft, fiberglass hardtop overhead, and then there are two tables fact, there's even a day bed on the port side forward. Thanks for walking through the Bering 65 with me. We only skimmed through some of my personal highlights today, but there's much more to the story. Please go to www.beringyachts.com for the latest updates, to read detailed specifications, see the layouts, options, and to find out more about the Bering Yachts brand.